to Selenium tutorials. So in this lesson, we will learn how to send external reports in email with screenshots. So most of the time, we are using absolute path. Right? So what is absolute path means? So you will get a complete path. So D drive or E drive project here, screenshots. So whenever we are sending the HTML reports like external reports in email, so as per take screenshot method, so we are giving absolute path system. Okay, dot get directory, get property, user dot directory and slash screenshot we are giving, right? So that is wrong. So that's why we are not able to see the screenshots in external report when we are sending to the client or some in the form of emails. So you need to use relative path. If you use the relative path, okay, so your path should be screenshot. Okay, so my screenshot will be saved under screenshot folder and my HTML report will be saved in report folder. So screenshot, remember this structure. Screenshot will be under screenshot folder. Okay, your HTML report will be under report. So in order to achieve this one, you need to append one single dot. Okay, so how we will see. So this one you already know. So I'm storing system util dot system dot get property user directory under report. I'm generating HTML file under report. So under report, this folder will come. Screenshots folder will come under report. Okay. If you have seen my structure, report under report screenshot will be there. So these are all same. You already know. So that's why I'm not going in depth. So if you have seen here, I have created one static object method. Log details like log where pass or fail something. Okay, test.log, log details, media entity details that is being captured from the path, image path, and dynamically I'm giving. So I want to pass in my method the build. I'm returning the test. Okay, this one you understood, right? This configuration you know how to. I'm using 3.1.5, so it will come in this format. Coming to take screenshot, like app screenshots method I have created, extend the utilities class. So static string method I have created, get screenshot. So I'm giving the name dynamically, screenshot name in the form of string. So when coming to here, see, image path you are seeing in the form of absolute path you are giving system.getProperty user.directory, right? So that is the wrong way. So you have to give the relative path, report, screenshot. I have explained here, right? Report, screenshot. Okay. Screenshots name, PNG, and file, this one source and destination, everything you know. And return the image path. This image I am returning. Okay. Now, coming to my test class, see. Extend, create test. This one, assign category, I have assigned, you already know. Okay. So I have that find element, this one I am sending the that Selenium. So now I want to take the screenshot. So what is my path? I want to take this as a screenshot. Okay. Now see screen capture. Okay. Screen capture. So I want to give some log. Testing. Google. Now the image path, what is the image path it will come? So what is the image path it will come? So for this you need to write one method. Say I will write the method. Okay. So here I need to get the screenshots and I need to append into external report. This is the app screenshots. Okay, dot get screenshot. Screenshot name I need to write. Okay. So this name I have printed here. This add those declaration. Okay, now I need to use this below method, screen capture method. Okay. So log you need to use. Okay, status dot pass. Here you need to add. Screen capture, just log details. So image path will be screenshot name. Right. Sorry, this one is not required. Okay. Now you need to call this pass screenshot, passer field. Shots and name you have to provide. What is the name? Google testing. So this one you have provided, right? Now let me run this one. So I'm using Google Chrome. Now it will open the Google and enter the search keyword and take the screenshot. Now it will take the screenshot. Okay, now go to here. So it is done, it is passed. Okay, now go to the folder screenshot name testing. It will not in this one. Okay, maybe what is wrong? Screenshot, screenshot name, pretty. Okay, let me open this one and see what will happen. So it is not giving. So if you click this one F12, if you go to here, let's see here. So it is, see, I'm not appending the single dot, right? I'm not appending the single dot. So that's why it is not coming. Now have to do C plus. So what is my string I'm given? Concatenate. So it will append the screenshots with dot. So now see, if you go to this get screenshot method, okay, screenshot name string, take screenshot input type file png. So here, why it is not showing means here you need to write. So this line is missing. So now, so what will happen? Now run as testNg test. Now it will open the Google and enter the search keyword. It will take the screenshot. So it is, I think it is done. It is passed. So now refresh here. Let me see what will happen. See, under it has, it came, right? Okay. See, under screenshot it came. So now open the folder. Remove this one. Google testing, it came, right? Now it will open. See, now you will able to see the screenshot. Now I will send this reports, complete report you need to send in the form of email. Okay, this one report, not even in the email, just I will show you copy. Okay, just paste it here. If you see here F12, press F12, you see the path here where it is showing. See, it is giving as relative path. See, source, go to source, file D, it is in the form of file, not in the form of absolute path. See, it is taking from the file. File D Selenium workspace. Okay. Now if I open same file, same HTML report from the desktop. Okay. Now see what will happen. If I open same from the desktop, it will display the screenshot. It is displaying, right? F12. Just see here what is the path it will see. Previously it was D Selenium workspace. Now it will display your low desktop. File C users or question. So this is my desktop. So if you use in this format, this is my format where it is. This is report screenshot. Now taking the screenshot, you need to append the one single dot. To that, this is the simple code. So you need to call this method wherever you want to require, or you can use after method. So after method also you can write this same thing here. Okay. So in this way you can send wherever you want to show that report to any client. You can should be send this report, but screenshot should be under screenshot, HTML report under here. So this is a format you need to compulsory maintain. So your HTML report will generate in the under reports, your screenshot should be under screenshot. So in this way you can send your, if you send same folder in the email, it will download. Okay, you need to download and unzip. So same thing it will happen for what I have shown you here. Same thing it will happen. Same it will display, it will take the relative path where the screenshot is exist. Okay. If you have any doubt, please message me in the form of comments under this video. Okay. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe and please provide your valuable comments on this solutions. So many people are struggling, right? I have struggled this one for around 15 days. At last I have found this one. So that's why I'm giving clear explanation to you, so that you can guide anyone. Like in this way we are generating and sending the reports to the client with the help of screenshots. Okay. Thank you for watching. Thank you guys.